Hello friends, this is Durga from IIT University. This video is part of a course called as CCA Data Analyst in which HiveScoop and Impala are covered quite extensively. If you want to learn any of these technologies or prepare for the certification, you can enroll for our course for $10 by going through the information in description. Also, we provide something called as Big Data Developer Labs. If you want to sign up for the labs and practice, you can actually go to the description and click on the link to get details about the labs. If you are not subscribed to our channel yet, please do so by clicking on the subscribe button and also click on notify button so that you get notified whenever we create free content as part of our channel. Let us get an overview of Impala Shell. Impala Shell is nothing but command line interface which can be used to connect to the Impala cluster and run queries against it. Typically, we have to connect to Impala D, which is nothing but the daemon process which is running on one of the worker nodes using Impala Shell, and then we should be able to submit the queries. But first, we need to connect to the gateway node of the cluster, and we should be using only the gateway node of the cluster to connect to any service that is running as part of our cluster, be it Hive or Impala or HDFS or anything. That being said, here I am connecting to the gateway node of this cluster, which is actually Big Data Server 1. Once we are on the gateway node of the cluster, we can actually say Impala Shell and hit enter. It will try to look for Impala daemon process running on that server itself on port number 21000. As there is no Impala daemon process running on this server, it actually failed. You can go to the cluster which we have, and then we can actually go to the Impala daemons. We have daemons only on Big Data Server 5, 6 and 7. But here it is trying to connect to Big Data Server 1 and it failed. The default port which it uses is nothing but 21000. Once you launch Impala Shell, if you want to connect to a particular Impala daemon which is part of our cluster, we can say connect Big Data Server -5, which is nothing but DNS alias for one of the servers on which Impala daemon is running. And then I can say port number 21000 and hit enter. All Impala commands ends with semicolon, so we have to type semicolon and then hit enter. Now it is connected to the Big Data Server 5:21000. Now we should be able to run queries any Hive commands like this. We can say tables to list the tables. As of now, there is only one table by name T. You can also say show databases to list the databases. There is a default database only. There are no other databases, and hence it is only showing default here. So this is how you should be able to launch Impala Shell. If you want to get the help on Impala Shell, you can say help here with semicolon. It will actually list the commands. You can say help set if you want to get the details with respect to set, and you can see the syntax about set. Same is the case with other commands that are available as part of documented commands. But if you try to get help on undocumented commands, you will not be getting any details here. Typically, all these undocumented commands are nothing but Hive commands, such as select query, create table, alter table, etc. That being said, we can also connect to the appropriate Impala daemon while launching the Impala Shell itself. To get all the options while launching Impala Shell, you can say Impala -shell, then -h or -help, and then hit enter. You should be able to see all the control arguments which can be passed using either hyphen or --, and then you can take it further. So in this case, if you have to connect to a particular Impala daemon while it is being launched, then you can actually say --impala-d equal to then the server name colon port number. So in this case, I can say Impala Shell --impala-d equal to Big Data Server -5:21000 and hit enter. It is directly connected to that daemon process which is running on Big Data Server 5. Now we should be able to run queries such as show tables or commands such as show tables to list the tables in the default database which is connected here. You can go through the list of other control arguments and you can understand the meaning of several of them just by glancing through them. You should be able to run the query also by using -q or --query. So instead of launching Impala Shell, it will just run the queries in interactive fashion. So here I can come out of this and then say Impala Shell --impala-d equal to Big Data Server -5:21000 and then --query equal to show tables and hit enter. You can see the list of tables here. Like that, you have other options also. You should be able to come up with all valid Impala commands or queries in a file, and you should be able to pass the file using -f. Kerberos is not relevant here, and hence I am not covering this here. If you want to save the output to your output file, you can pass the output file like this. If you want to override any properties with respect to Impala, you can actually put them in a file and you should be able to pass that file here. You can also pass arguments to Impala CLI by saying --var equal to keyval. This is how you should be able to pass the key and value, and you should be able to access the values by passing the keys at runtime. So these are several options which you should focus on and understand as much as you can. And then you have to start using these things as you proceed further. Now I am launching the Impala shell once again. Once it is launched, if you want to get the history, you can say history and you should be able to see the previous commands that are executed. Also, if you say help and hit enter, there are other important commands also. You can use shell to actually run any valid Linux shell command. So in this case, if I want to get the list of files from the directory using which we actually launched this Impala shell, then I can say shell space ls-ltr. And then you should be able to list the files in this directory from where we have launched this Impala shell. You can also run the HDFS related commands by saying shell Hadoop fs-ls, let's say user itversity, to just list the files in that HDFS location, and you should be able to see the output here. So any valid shell command can be run using shell. It is very important to understand this, because if you have to load data from local file systems into a particular HDFS location before loading into Impala, you might have to run these shell commands, and hence you have to practice these things, or you need to at least understand how to issue shell commands from the Impala so that you can actually develop the scripts. That being said, as we proceed further and start creating the tables, then try loading data into those tables, we will actually see the relevance of these commands. We should be able to use this shell command effectively to get data into HDFS location before loading into the tables using Impala itself. So make sure you are comfortable with these things, or at least have an idea about how to use these features to accomplish whatever you want to as part of your projects, or even if it is required for the certification exams.